Hello and welcome to this Minecraft Let's Play. I was talking with my friends and we were talking about the Lego games. And I was basically saying that, you know, although they're good fun in their own little way, they don't really capture the spirit of Lego for me. You know, they are just platformers with a sort of a Lego theme or scrolling beat-em-ups or whatever you want, but you know, they don't really give you that feeling that you had when you were a kid playing with Lego. So then the conversation got round to Minecraft. Now it turns out that I seem to be the last person in existence to have not heard of Minecraft. I don't know where I've been. I mean, I play a lot of PC games. I don't know why I haven't heard of this game before, but it sounds, from the very little I've been told about it, it does sound amazing. And the reason I've been told very little about it is we did decide quite early on that I would do a Let's Play, and they thought it would be good, certainly for the first few episodes, if I did it blind, a blind Let's Play. They said, you know, it's better to go into it blind than to know the sort of what happens in the game. Although I do have some ideas about some of the game. I bought a copy of Minecraft and I gave my laptop to my friends and they took it away and they installed loads of mods and texture packs and stuff to really not so much change the game, they say, but really add things to it that either were missing or done poorly in the original game. I don't know what they've done. I will read out a list of the mods that have been installed, but this means nothing to me at the minute. I'm sure it'll come to mean something. Okay, so we have the Somnia mod, which apparently makes sleep work properly. We have the Armor Stand mod. We have the Audio mod. We have Better Than Wolves, which adds mechanical power and loads of other stuff. We have Matte Moss, which improves the environmental effects. We have Mo Creatures, which adds more creatures. Ore Redistribution, which makes ore clump together into more realistic formations. Infinite Biomes, more paintings. Nature Overhaul, which gives trees and plants life cycles and they grow, die, and forests spread and sprawl, whatever. Okay, I'm sure all of this will make more sense to me once I've actually played the game. Okay, so we've got Rando Mobs, which allows mobs to have different skins. Shelf, Survivalism, which adds hunger, thirst, and tiredness. And finally, we have Walled City, which allows ruined walled cities to spawn in the game. Okay, so that's the mods. We're using a texture pack which apparently it's based on Miso's texture pack, but there are all sorts of other additions and changes and tweaks made to it from other people's texture packs, but the friend who set this up doesn't know what he's used, because this is his own texture pack and he's been building up for years, so he doesn't know what's in there, whose work it is. He knows it's mostly based on Miso's, but apologies, I can't give proper credit to the author of the texture pack or the various texture packs used. Okay, so I have also been given a list of recipes. Well, it's a book of recipes. There's an awful lot of them, a sort of a quick explanation, which I've kind of read as to how that works, and also a guide to your first day in Minecraft, which emphasises the importance of building a shelter and making torches. But we'll get onto that, and we may as well start without too much further ado. Okay, so create new world. Right. As it is my first, we should call it Cradle. I don't know why, just the word is in my head. Okay, so, create new world. Okay. Right, well, here we are. Okay, WASD, that's good. Right, well, first impressions are, it certainly is blocky. It is like the world is made up out of Lego, that's for sure. Or as close to Lego as you can get without treading on, you know, anyone's copyrighted IP, I guess. Are they sharks? Yeah, they look like sharks. Okay, I probably don't want to just go swimming across to that island or whatever thing. Yeah, so here we are. I appear to have woken up on a beach. I guess I've been shipwrecked or something, because apparently I'm completely alone in this land. So I would assume that perhaps I've been shipwrecked, or you know, found myself washed up on this rather odd desert beach. Beach. It's not really a desert beach, is it? It's more of a forest kind of a region. Right, so following this guideline to your first day, or surviving your first day in Minecraft, the first instruction I'm given is is that a duck? That's a chicken. That just made a chicken noise. That looks to be like a duck, or some really obscure variety of chicken. It must be a duck, a mallard, surely. Look, there's another one up here. Okay, anyway. So yeah, I mustn't get distracted, because apparently it is really important to, these trees are crazy. And look at that, that's, I suppose these are branches, but they're made up out of single blocks. And even the leaves, look, are actually blocks. Okay, so, right, let's find a smallish tree. Right, so, apparently, I've got to, if I approach one of these blocks and I push and hold the left mouse button, it's gonna break it, and then I can pick it up. Right, and then I can continue to break blocks, like so. And the idea is I need to collect as many pieces of these trunks as I can. Right, okay. So after you've chopped down a small tree and taken all the wood, press I for inventory, then go pick up the wood that you've taken and put it into your crafting box. Yes, okay, so then you can take wooden planks made from the wood. Right, so I guess I'm that wood that I've collected, I've just chopped it all down into wooden planks. Okay, now if you take 4 of those wooden planks, right, and then place them 1 in each of your crafting box, you can create a crafting table. Okay, brilliant. Now place that in your quick bar. Sorry, I'm just reading the instructions here that I've been given. And then right click to place any block. No, that doesn't work. Ah, okay. Right. So I've created this crafting table, and then I've and it itself is also a block, and I wonder if I can just place any block like that. Okay, so yep. I guess that's how you build. I mean, that's the equivalent of you know, if I push this, it kind of turns into a collectible. I see. And then if I do this, then I put it back down again. Okay, that's fairly neat. That works. And then I use my crafting grid to change them into different things. So if I right click on this, what I want to do now is make sticks. What I'm trying to do is make an axe, because an axe makes chopping down trees much, much quicker. So for an axe, I need 2 things. I need a handle and I need a head. And apparently I can make a head out of wood, but I need sticks to make the handle. So I'm gonna need to if you put wooden planks one above the other, anywhere in the crafting box it says, then you can make sticks. So we'll make 4 sticks. And bring that back. And then this is the recipe for an axe. There it is, a wooden axe. And now, can I leave that? No, clearly not. Okay, so now I've got a wooden axe, which has a hole in the top of it. That doesn't look great. Okay, now apparently I can chop down trees much quicker just by targeting the bottom post, and it should fell the tree properly. So, well, how properly is it going to fell it? I mean, do I have to take into consideration if it's going to fall, it's going to fall this way by the laws of physics. I guess I just do the same. Oh, okay. Alright, I see. So it just turns every block into a collectible, which oh, I see, the leaves are kind of disappearing on their own account. I guess otherwise it would just leave a giant canopy up there with no trunk actually attached to it. Okay, so I've been told, the next instruction says, using this method, building axes as you need, collect 100 pieces of wood. So, is that another one up there? Yeah. Okay. Right.